Hello, I am Jan from Prague, the Czech Republic, and in this video, let's explore what to expect from taking photos with the Samsung Galaxy S24 Ultra. We'll take a quick look together at about 250 test photos taken in a number of locations from Prague in foggy winter haze to South Moravian vineyards in spring light. And as always, we'll be interested not only in what this mobile phone can do, but also in the general trends of mobile photography. What will you see in this video? First, we'll summarize the key parameters, what lenses and sensors this mobile has, and what to expect from them. So, we'll also explore how zooming to really long distances works and why it sometimes makes sense to shoot at the maximum resolution of 200 megapixels. And then, we'll go on a rather long journey from Prague's lesser town with many wonderful animals to the vineyards of South Moravia. And I'll show you more than 250 test photos, which will tell you what this mobile can actually offer. So, let us jump directly into it. Samsung Galaxy S24 Ultra has 5 lenses and 5 sensors. One is in the front side, and then we have 4 in the back side. One ultra wide, then the main, and then we have 2 telezoom. One is 3 times, the other is 5 times. Let's see some examples. Obviously, these are shots from the ultra-wide lens, ultra-wide sensor, which are sometimes overlooked by some users, which is a pity because they can really give us a power of really squeezing a lot of space into the frame. Obviously, the price might be that it all seems a little bit distorted, but at the same time, just do not overlook it. It can give you a lot of power in very complex situations, like when you'd be shooting peacocks and suddenly peacock starts flying towards you. The ultra-wide angle is really useful. And then here is the main lens, main sensor, which has 200 megapixels. We'll get into it in a much bigger detail just for this beginning couple of shots of the vineyards down in south of Moravia to these lovely animals in the banks of Prague's Vltava River and some details. And of course, that lens and that sensor have a huge role in the portrait mode. But if you really want to get the portrait in more photographic sense, then telezooms would be better choice. So here are some examples of the zooming. And I have to say, and I'll say it a couple of times more, the great feature of this camera is this very simple fact that it is so universal that you are able very quickly switch between sensors and lenses and various situations, and I really liked it. And let's explore it in a bigger detail. I guess that there can be no review of any mobile phone without some discussions about zooming capabilities. So let's do it right here with that my favorite testing tower in the downtown Prague. So that would be ultra wide, and now we are getting closer and closer. This is 3 times, 5 times. So the most important lens, because that sensor, I didn't mention it before, has 50 megapixels, which really counts and which actually gives us the option to have very good results when we zoom up to 10, which is here, and it's obviously the digital zoom, but it's the quality is still really good. And we can go to 30, which is here, and the 30 is still reasonably good. And as you would probably guess, there is also the option to zoom to 100. And let me just go back. So that is, once again, you even can't see the tower behind the tower, but it's still there. And this is 30, this is 100. Well, I still sort of do not get how that is done. Yes, of course, a lot of recalculating is behind that, a lot of probably adjustment also, but still you can see so many details. Just do not get me wrong. Of course, that is a level of magnification which is, for me, unusable. But I have to say that, of course, 10 is fine, and even 30 makes sense under certain conditions. Let's see it in one more example. Southern Moravia, white, and we go closer and closer and closer and closer. This is 30, and this is 100. Well, again, I would not use it, But for the record, it's good to mention it's there and it does really work. A part of the charm why we can zoom so much is done by the simple fact that that mobile has the magic of 200 megapixels. Well, years ago I was rather critical about the meaning of it because there, well, it was just a selling point basically, but not anymore. And it plays a really important role for the moment when we really want to zoom or want to get some details out of the shot. Well, so that is a normal shot taken in 12 megapixels. So you can't really read what is written here. Well, you can, but you can't see the details. But you have the option to turn on the shooting into 200 megapixels. And look at what happens. Suddenly the details are there. So once again, that is the original shot and we zoom to that part and that's what we get. And just to compare it, this is the normal shot with 12 megapixels and that one would be a really huge crop. Just look at this, it's how far we are, but it still does make sense. So I really think it's important to note that under certain circumstances, it does indeed make sense to use the maximum of 200 megapixels, even for shots like that. One more example, which I really liked, we have peacocks arguing here in the garden of Prague. And look at this, this is shot at 200 megapixels and these are cropped photos from it. And again, I'm really, really, really politely surprised how good these crops are. So the meaning of 200 megapixels is not that much to impress your friends in a pub, but sometimes to use it when you need to capture a lot of details or eventually to crop. So that's it. And now let me invite you for a rather long trip through the gardens of Prague and other places in my Czech Republic. And I'll actually show you a lot of photos because, you know, it's quite often reviews have just a couple of photos, just a selection of the best of the best. And I think it's important for you to have a really huge collection of photos rolling in the front of your eyes just to get some idea what to expect from that camera or that mobile phone. And I'm starting here with the peacocks. We've already seen them. And the reason why I am starting with them is the simple fact that for me, that garden with the peacocks in the very center of the lesser town, just under the Prague castle, is an amazing testing ground. And I take a lot of my cameras or mobile phones here for testing. And I'm just trying to do the thing you would be doing if you were the mobile, just to do some really complex and complicated shooting. As you can see here, the bird is even flying towards me. So the wide, ultra wide lens is really handy. And what I am telling to tell you is what you should see from that collection is that the universality, your ability to change lenses and sensors and capture things which are rather distant is just amazing. And if you ask me what is the simple most important reason why you should be impressed by that camera, this is it. The ability to go anywhere and use the zoom, well, you should be careful a little bit because of course not all photos would be great, but still the ability to be in a distance and zoom and then use ultra wide and then zoom again is just amazing. And I was really, really impressed. And some really close-ups of these lovely animals here in the city of Prague. And here we go. What do you think? Let us change location and let's jump to a Samsung action, to a Samsung event. And well, it doesn't really matter that it's Samsung, but what really matters is that I had a chance to test another quite important part of any mobile I'm testing. It means portrait mode. And again, I think a couple of pictures are worth more than 1,000 words, and you can see that the results are quite impressive, I have to admit, either if you use wide lens or if you just turn on the proper mode of portrait, which would mean zooming or using 3 or 5 times lens. And you can see that the results are amazing. Again, let me stress that all these shots, and not only these, but every single shot in that video has not been processed, are really JPEGs directly from the card. So I didn't retouch it, I didn't edit it. And I was just using natural light, and I think you see what I want you to see, that you won't be disappointed either in these locations just behind the window or the doors, or at these shots by bar, which are just deeper in the building, deeper in the venue with different light. And if you want to see some more natural light, here are some more examples, and the blur is, well, impressive, I have to say. Of course, do not forget that that is software. It's not naturally blurred by optics. It's done by the algorithm in your mobile phone, but still it counts. Okay, let's see some more shots from the Samsung Action, some details, some macro photos. I think quite impressive results. And sorry for repeating it again and again, but I have to say it. The great thing about that flagship Samsung is very simple. It's so universal. You can shoot so many different types of photos that you want. Of course, since I like to play with various technical specifications, I just could not resist to test the zooming again. And you can see I'm zooming from ultra wide to 30 and even to 100, which is here, well, yeah. And it's up to you if you like it or not. I like it as an example of things the engineers can do now. If it can be used in a real life, I'm not so sure, but it's really interesting. What is example from the same spot, same place, here with the Prague trams, and again, I'm changing my zooms, my sensors. And yes, of course, if you are really take a closer look, you might see that the details might not be perfect in all these shots. But again, you see that I'm changing settings so quickly and the results you get are quite impressive. So let's walk further through the Prague, and I can't resist shooting. Maybe the reason is that I have my own personal iPhone 15 Pro, which, as you know, can't really do any of these things because it can't zoom. So I like to play with the Samsung to do some really proper zooming, either up to 30 or even to 100 again. But as you already know, that would not be really usable in a real life. Some more shots from my favorite places in Prague, and ultra wide lens again in action. This is the place where I do a lot of training, so you see that of course it's distorted, but it's still there and it counts. And the beautiful city of Prague, and another day, and the angle of the light is not polite to any optics, but still you can get quite reasonable results. And you know that there is so many different topics to shoot. Birds, people, bridges, water, a lot of things. And the results, again, it's up to you to make your judgment, but I was quite satisfied. Of course, it'll be to a great extent up to you how much will you be zooming. For instance, that is too much for me, or this is even further in the territory I would never touch. But if you really want to have a shot just to remind you of your beautiful trip, maybe, why not? Just remind you how far am I, and I can zoom up here, and all these shots are still in the territory of, well, you can use it. What makes much bigger sense for me are shots like that, where you zoom up to 10 or up to 20 and you get a category of shots which is really important. Of course, if you are into photography for a couple of years, you know that at the end of the day, what really matters are shots like that, when you are at a wide angle and you are in a very short distance to the animal, and you have not only the animal as such, but also the context, and then the photos are able to deliver much more emotions and much more, you know, memories and so on. Well, you can guess what the emotion is here. The poor animal is asking me whether I might provide some food. Unfortunately, I didn't have any food, so he suggested that I go away, which I eventually did, but some more shots of these beautiful animals you can very easily find on the banks of the Vltava River, directly in the city of Prague. And now we jumped to a totally different location, to the south of Moravia, which you might not know is very famous for its wine. And I was invited to a Synology event, and I was just testing, of course, what the mobile phone can do. And do not be too critical about these shots, because what you can't tell from them is that they were shot in a really, 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 really bad light. You wouldn't be able to read under that light. It was so dark. But still, the camera was able to capture a lot of details. Yes, the ISO must have been quite high, so there would be noise into the shots. But still, I was quite politely surprised that even under these terrible conditions, the mobile is able to produce some reasonable shots. And if you do not want to listen to the music, we can go directly to the cellar and some more testing with ultrawide and zooms and candles and complex lights and hidden old bottles of wine and so on. So once again, take this as one of the examples of how that mobile can be used in various situations with quite reasonable results. In the morning, during the breakfast, I just noticed that amazing motorbike. And the reason why I'm showing it to you is that please do not forget that the portrait mode, as you can see here, can be used not only for people, but also for details, motorbikes, pretty much anything. So that's what's used here, and the blurred background is something which really counts. So take this as another example of the universality of that mobile phone. Let's go to the vineyards once again, and you've seen that building from my zooming test. So once again, 30 and 100. Well, I wouldn't go that far in the real life, but for shots like that, you suddenly realize that you can get really, really a lot of close-ups. You can really zoom. Yes, of course, if you are around 30, you'll be able to use the results more or less just for social media. You will not be able to print it for big prints, big photos. You'll need some level of experience to tell where the border lies for use. It means when you say, okay, I just want to have that shot printed out, so I should not zoom over 10, say, or 20. But if you just do not care, you can really zoom wherever you want and you'll be still quite satisfied, even in really wild situations and wild light. Of course, I'm not showing you all the photos. Certainly not every single photo would be amazing, would be great. But the reason why am I throwing all these examples to you is very simple. I just want you to see what you'll see if you buy that phone. And as I say, I'm trying to keep my reviews in that mode, just to take the camera or a mobile phone, to keep it in my pocket for a couple of weeks at least, and then just, well, give you a chance to see what you'll get if you get the same one. The nature, these beautiful views were on our side and on the mobile side, of course, because it was just beautiful to see all these greenish parts of Moravia in this beautiful spring light. Just gives us a great chance to get nice shots. But if the mobile would not be good, you wouldn't get these shots. One more important chapter. Of course, you'll be buying that mobile also for taking video shots. And I have to admit, and I have admitted it in every single review I've done over years, is that I'm not a really big specialist in video. Well, I do a lot of videos, but I'm not able to tell you whether the video which Samsung S24 Ultra will give you is better or worse than this mobile or this mobile. I just can't do it. So the only thing I can do is the thing I am doing right now. So as I speak, I am showing to you some examples of videos I have taken during these couple of weeks of testing, and it's up to you to make your opinion about that. Of course, the results are good, great. I was quite satisfied. The Samsung S24 Ultra can shoot up to 8K, which I did not test much because I'm not sure if it has really place in the real world. But all these video recordings are made in 4K, which of course make much bigger sense and are much useful. And again, I was quite satisfied. So thank you so much for your attention. I do indeed hope I gave you some inspiration, and take care. I'm Jan from Prague, the Czech Republic.